I'm glad that I have the privilege of sharing my experience in conducting studies of nicotine-containing products. In my presentation, I would like to underline the importance of clinical research center right selection to demonstrate the reliability and safety data of nicotine-containing products. First of all, in order to introduce you to the topic, I would like to start with some basic facts. Despite general acceptance that smoking is harmful, a substantial number of adults continue to smoke. The development of potential reduced exposure products, more recently termed modified risk tobacco products, has been suggested as a way to reduce a risk of tobacco smoking. Valid human clinical trials is critical to determining the risk and benefits from these products. And the most important is the safety of the subject and reliability of delivered data. This is a picture which demonstrates that over the world we have 146 recruiting studies regarding the tobacco products. US appears to be indisputable leader in conducting studies of nicotine, with 120 trials right now. But Europe comes second with 14 recruiting studies at the moment. Selecting the appropriate center is of paramount importance to conduct study and receive professional data. So let's find answers to the following questions. How to find the right clinical research center? What kind of expertise should the center possess? And are there any regulations regarding the centers? The study can be conducted at various places. Firstly, we can run the project at a research center without any formal regulations, or choose a clinical research center which is highly regulated. I would like to highlight that clinical research center should be taken into account when sponsor places the study of tobacco products as well. You may ask why. The answer is simple. Clinical research center possesses standardization of the process and they have experience in conducting a complicated study in terms of large number of procedures in short time. There are two main regulations concerning clinical research centers. First is issued by European Medicine Agency, and second concerns certainty for phase one clinical trials. But to my mind, I reckon that sponsors should consider phase one unit as a potential site for the studies of tobacco products as well. The British recommendation, for example, describes in great details who is allowed to conduct the study, as there are high requirements for the staff of the center. What seems to be the most crucial is having an experienced team which obtains general trainings, study-specific trainings, and permanent trainings in emergency procedures. It was mentioning that particular site should be well prepared to conduct procedures timely. It's highly advisable to do study-specific mock trainings to check the feasibility of the procedures over the time. Usually, we check subject's path, the way of tested product, and sample route. It's important due to fact that very often product is planned to be applied every 2 minutes. Blood sampling is planned to be drawn every 5 minutes. And we have to check in real conditions how much time it will take. Because in real time, with real subjects, there is no time for the experiment. The role of experienced clinical research site is to collaborate with the sponsor to draw up a feasible, viable study protocol where sponsor expectations about results are met. Thus, clinical research site plays a role of an expert and advisor, having deep background in dealing with studies in general. I would like to refer to two cases where we had to work out the best possible way to conduct the study. In first case, we received detailed study protocol where time for performance of each procedure was set in advance in the study flow. Looks on the last line, day number 5, and according to the protocol, we had to perform several procedures over one minute at 8 exactly. We should take a blood for the PK, blood for safety, urine sample, ECG, HR, PB. Subjects should have should eat breakfast at the unit, and physical examination, including skin exam, should be performed exactly at 8. It's how to do this? It's impossible within 1 minute. So in this case, we recommended to divide the procedures in time to avoid deviations. In case 2, protocol state that we had to have to take blood using 1.5 meter long line for the blood sampling. It's impossible as well. So in this case, we changed this in the final protocol as well. Quality management system supervises the whole system of work at Clinical Research Center. This system consists of COPs, internal audits and controls, supervising the implementation of external audits recommendations, and trainings. Additionally, I would like to mention that guidelines for phase 1 clinical trials exactly indicate that sponsor is responsible for the quality, but also units should have their own system, for example, ISO certificate. What is important for specific tobacco study? Primary thing is to make sure there is no regulations or legislation that prevent from performing smoking events as required in the protocol. Even the best clinical site with the indoor smoking ban is not suitable for the smoking studies. After that, when we are sure that in this place we can smoke, we can focus on other things, such as access to the smoker populations, experience in conducting smoking studies, experience in human smoking topography, and experience in performing spirometry. Another important thing is checking how smoking areas look like. In my opinion, there should be a significant number of dedicated smoking areas for all arms of smokers. Smoking areas should be within the premises of the clinic. Otherwise, the pathway from the clinic to the smoking areas should be monitored and supervised by the study personnel. And finally, we have to remember about ethics issues. From our previous experience, there were no general objections to the aim of the studies we performed. Some ethical issues were related to the questions if study for subjects would not encourage them to smoke more cigarettes. And finally, it's good to know that all studies must obtain ethics committee's approval. To sum up, I would like to focus on key points to ensure that study performed at selected center deliver the reliable safety data of nicotine-containing products. First of all, close communication with the sponsor. QA procedures are equally important. We cannot forget about well-trained, experienced staff and good organization. As for the sponsor, it is crucial to find the site with large database of needed subjects. Additionally, site should have experience in 24 urine collection and appropriate equipment. And above all, site should be aware of the risk and thus have a risk management policy. Whatever I have said so far is based on our long experience in conducting clinical studies, including experience in smoking studies. So far, we have been involved in 3 projects of nicotine-containing products and randomized around 500 subjects. Besides, in the last 15 years of operations, we have conducted more than 200 studies in general. Thank you for your attention.